Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, great. Can you see me?
Yes, I can see you.
Nice. Okay, so I like your background, Andy.
Oh, that is every day.
You'd like to choose another background?
This is every day's recommend.
Ah, you mean every day's recommendation?
Yes, that daily recommendation.
Yes, thank you for that one, Andy. So now, Andy, how are you today?
I feel good today.
Okay, nice. So, let me see. Did you have an exam during the day?
I have an English exam today.
So, how was the English exam?
The English exam is very hard.
Do you think you passed the exam?
Maybe I passed.
Yeah,
I'm not sure.
hopefully you passed. Okay, so did you have the
Maybe I will get 35
35 out of?
out of 40.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Yes.
But let me see, 40 times. What's the percentage of a passing score? Is it 80 or 75?
Oh, sorry.
What's the percentage of passing score? Is it 80% or
Oh,
75?
40%. Right?
The total items is 40%. I 40. That's the
Yeah.
total items of the exam. How about the percentage rate? Is it 80%? If the percentage rate is 80%, then you have to get at least 32. Yes, and that means you're passing.
Okay.
Yes, but anyway, Andy, please take a look at the book on the screen. Can you see it?
Yes, I can see it.
Okay, so now, do you have your book with you?
Yes, I have. And I don't know what page
Okay,
is.
so I think we are now in page 46.
Forty-six.
Yeah.
Okay, I open it.
Let me double check if it's really 46. 43, 40. Oh, I'm sorry. This is page 44, Andy.
40.
44, grammar
Oh,
comparison 40.
yes, I opened it.
Yes. Okay, so now, Andy, are you ready to start?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, so yesterday, Andy, we ended up describing this picture, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now let's proceed immediately with task two. So in here, you're going to read the dialogue and ignoring the gaps and check your ideas from task one. Okay, can you please read this dialogue? So this is what the girls or the women have been talking in that picture in task one. So can you please read? So this time, Andy, we will read it together. You will be Jenny and I will be Beth.
Okay, I think this flat is the best we've seen so far. They are all quite expensive. Rents seem to be getting higher and higher, but this one's the least expensive and is nearest to the city center.
But it's the one with the fewest rooms and the least space.
So you prefer the flat in the badly location and with the highest rent?
The location isn't as bad as you think. It's far from the city center than the other two, but you can get to the train station and the university more easily, and it's much spacious than the other two flats.
Okay. We can we afford it though? The more we spend on rent, the less we'll have for other things.
Actually, it's less expensive than it seems because the rent includes all the bills. So this is what the two the women were talking in the previous picture. So now, Andy, in here, the people are looking at property to rent. They are discussing which would be the best for them. And this is what they were saying to each other. Okay. So now, Andy, in here, do you have any question about the dialogue?
Yes, I understand.
Okay, so that means no question, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now let's proceed with comparative and superlative forms. So why do we use comparative and superlative? So first, we use comparative when comparing two nouns. Okay, then we use the superlative form when comparing more than three nouns or when we compare a group. So here, I'm going to read this. The comparative and superlative forms of adjectives and adverbs with one syllable are formed by adding ER. So comparative, we just add ER. And for the superlative form, we just add EST. For example, prettier, prettiest.
Oh, okay. Bigger, biggest.
That's right. Okay, so the same is true of adjectives with two syllables ending in Y. So in here, we have the subject Zoe is, okay, thinner than Toby or younger than Toby. So in this one, since we're comparing Zoe and Toby, so there are only two people, then we use the comparative form by just adding ER. And in the case that if the adjective ends with Y, we just have to change Y into I and add ER. Or remove Y, then just add IER. Then it becomes lazier.
Oh, okay.
Yes, same with pretty. Okay, P-R-E-T-T-Y. So remove I, then just add remove Y and just add IER. Prettier. Okay, so that is when we compare two people or things. Now here it is. If the subject is the subject is Zoe. Zoe works faster than Toby. So we just add ER. Okay, so do you have any question about comparative form?
Yes, I understand.
Okay, great. So now, Andy, let's take a look with superlative. So here, Zoe, the subject is the same. We're talking about Zoe. Zoe is the youngest. Even though that we cannot see other people in this sentence, but we assume that Zoe is compared to a group. Let's just say in a class. So Zoe is the youngest. Okay, so we use superlative when we compare a person to a group. Then here, Andy, we just add EST. But before the adjective in here is young. So we add the, then add EST, the youngest. Zoe is the youngest. Another example, Zoe is the thinnest. Okay. And for this case, Andy, thin, we just double the N and add EST. So the spelling changes because we have to double the consonant N, then add EST to make it superlative form. And next we have lazy, same with the comparative form, we just remove the y and add iest. But of course, we put the before the adjective, the laziest. Zoe is the laziest.
Oh.
Do you understand okay. this one, Andy?
Yes, I understand.
Okay, and in here, Zoe works. So works is a verb. Okay, so in here, it's the same. Zoe works the fastest. Okay, so this one we use is because this is the linking verb. So any question about this?
No, I don't have question.
Okay, so now Andy, if I'm going to use the adjective tall, what would be the superlative form? It becomes Zoe is.
Zoe is.
Okay, if the adjective is tall, so how can I describe Zoe by using superlative form? The sentence will go, Zoe is
tallest.
Yes, that's right. But don't forget to put the. Zoe is the tallest. Okay, when we use superlative form of the adjective, we always put the before the superlative form. Okay?
Okay.
Great. So now, do you have any questions about this?
No, I don't have question.
Okay. Now let's take a look with the next one. So we have here more examples of comparative and superlative. So we have more and we use more and most, Andy, if the adjective syllable are more than two or more than one, just like intelligent, intelligent. So that's four syllables.
Okay.
Generous. How many syllables for generous? We have generous. There are three syllables.
Okay, generous.
So how about pretty? How many syllables?
Pretty, two.
Yes, that's right. It's good because you understand syllables. So if the adjective has two syllables or more than two, then for the comparative form, we use more before the adjective. Just like this one, Zoe is more intelligent than Toby. Another example, Zoe is more generous than Toby. We don't say Zoe is intelligenter than Toby. No, there's no word as intelligenter. We cannot even say Zoe is generouser. No, we use more because generous and intelligent have more than two syllables.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And even with this one, clearly, how many syllables are there in the word clearly?
Clearly, two syllables.
Very good. So what would be the comparative form?
Oh, sorry?
What would be the comparative form for clearly? We add?
Clearing.
We add more. Zoe writes more clearly than Toby.
Okay.
Yeah, so again, for comparative, we always add more if the adjective have more than two syllables. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, so now, how about for superlative? So here, for superlative, we use most. So it's the same if the adjective has at least two or more syllables, then we put most. We use most for the superlative, but we always add the most generous. Zoe is the most generous. Zoe writes the most clearly. Any questions, Andy?
No.
Okay, so since you don't have any question, I'm gonna ask you a question.
Okay.
Why do we use the most for superlative form?
Because though is actually is this though means life?
Zoe is a person.
Because Zoe are
Zoe is.
Oh, Zoe are generous.
Yes, because Zoe is generous. So why is it we use the most? Because generous has.
General have the most.
Okay, because the word generous has three syllables. Generous. There are three. That's why we use the most. And we also use the most because we are comparing Zoe in a group.
Okay,
so now I assume that you understand the comparative and superlative form. So let's take a look with this one. So we can also form comparative and superlatives of adjectives and adverbs with less and least. Okay, so less is the opposite of more. And least is the opposite of most. Example, Toby is less intelligent than Zoe. Toby is less thin than Zoe. Or Toby writes less clearly than Zoe. So okay. Less is for comparative and least is superlative. Can you please make the sentence for this one? Toby is...
Toby is higher than the Zoe.
Toby is the least generous.
Toby is the least generous than Toby.
Okay, so for superlative, Andy, we don't say than anymore. The sentence is just Toby is the least generous. Because in this sentence, we can understand that Toby is compared to a group, not just to Zoe.
Okay.
But in comparative, we use than Zoe because we are only comparing two person in a comparative comparative form.
Okay.
And next we have Toby writes the least clearly. Okay, so now, Andy, how many people can we compare by using comparative form? Or how many people should we compare in using comparative form?
Two or more.
Only two. Comparative is only two. How about superlative?
One.
Superlative. That's three or more.
Oh, okay.
Superlative is for groups, then comparative is just two.
Okay.
So now let's take a look with the next one. So in here, I want you to take a look at these examples. So here we can use less and least with uncountable nouns. Again, Andy, what is uncountable nouns?
That means we cannot count it. Like very difficult. Like the here.
Air.
Here.
Here, like this one? Oh,
yes.
Hair. Can you please say it again? Hair.
Hair.
Great. Yes, you are correct. Hair, we cannot count the hair because it takes us forever to count it. So now in here, we use less or least with uncountable noun. Again, less is comparative and least is superlative. Okay? Example, I've got less spare time than you. So what is the uncountable noun in here, Andy?
Springtime.
Spare time. Can you please say spare time?
Spare time.
Okay, so do you know spare time?
Relax time.
That's right. Or available time to relax. Very good. So now here it is. Who's got the least money? So now, Andy, why do we use less in here?
I've got less spray time than you. The uncountable nouns is spare time and other was more.
Here it is. So my question is, why do we use less in this sentence?
Because they use than.
Than. Very good. So you are trying to say that less is used in this sentence because we compare two people. I and you. That's okay. Two. So that is for comparative. Okay. And now for this one, Andy, who's got the least money? In this sentence, what is the uncountable noun?
Money.
Very good. So why do we use least?
Because money cannot count.
Okay, so we use least because we are asking a group of people who's got the least money. So we are assuming that there are more than three people that we are asking. That means it is superlative.
Okay.
So the answer to the question, why do we use least? Because this sentence is superlative.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And here, can you please read number two?
We often use of after superlative adjectives.
We often use of after, can you please say superlative?
Superlative.
Yes, superlative adjective. So in here, example, Jamie is the smallest of the three brothers. So in superlative sentence or superlative adjectives, we use of. Okay, just like this one. Jamie is the smallest. So now how many people are mentioned or being compared in this sentence?
This is the most.
I will repeat my question. How many people are being compared in this sentence?
Three.
Okay, no. So let's see.
Yeah, maybe it's four.
Exactly, it's four because we compare three brothers and Jamie. 3 + 1, 4. Okay, so now, why is this superlative? Why do we use superlative adjective, Andy? Because
they have three or more, so this is superlative form.
Very good, wow. Okay, so now, here, we also use in, not, of, with, for a group or place. For example, the best cafe in Oxford. Okay, the most intelligent boy in the class. The longest river in Africa. Okay, because Oxford, class, and Africa are big groups. Okay, and in here, can you please read number three? We can make
comparisons with classes as well as with nouns.
Okay, thank you for reading that one. Can you please say comparisons?
Comparisons.
Nice. So in here, we can still make comparisons with clauses as well as with nouns. So examples. Gemma is more intelligent than you think. Okay. The weather is hotter than it was last week. So in here, we used more intelligent because we are comparing Gemma to what you think. So what than you think is a clause. And another example, last week is also a noun. It was last week, then it becomes clause. So here, what type of adjective is more intelligent? Is it comparative or superlative?
Comparative.
That's right. How about hotter? Comparative or superlative?
This is cannot count, so this is superlative.
Hold on. So let's take a look with hotter. What kind of adjective is this? Is this comparative or superlative?
Oh, this is more. So this is a comparative.
That's right, because of ER.
Yes.
So now, do you have any questions about this?
Yeah, I have.
Okay, what is it?
Is it ER for comparative and ET for the superlative?
Okay, so yes, you are correct. ER for comparative, but for superlative, we usually add EST.
Okay, I know now.
And if the syllables are more than three or more than two, then the comparative is more. Okay, then the superlative is most. So here, Andy, when we use the superlative, we put the prettiest, the most generous.
Okay.
So any more questions or clarification?
No.
Okay. Now let's take a look with this one. Can you please read number four? We often use
a superlative with the present, prefer, and either.
Okay. So can you please say perfect?
Perfect.
Ever.
Ever.
Okay. We often use a superlative with the present, perfect, and ever. So here, Andy, this is an example of a present perfect sentence by using ever. Alex has got the biggest dog I've ever seen. Okay, so in this sentence, what is the adjective?
Biggest.
Very good. Now, what is biggest? Is that comparative or superlative?
It's superlative.
Very good. Okay, and for number five, we can compare two things using not as. Example, Julie is as tall as Mike. That means that they have the same height.
Okay. Okay.
So in here, we can also use not as. Then that is a negative form. Leia is not or isn't as tall as Joe. This means that Joe is taller than Leia. Okay.
Okay.
So both of them and D are what we call comparative adjective. As tall as or isn't as tall as. That is comparative.
Okay.
Okay. And number six, we use double comparatives to emphasize that something is changing. So this is C, not S. Okay, we use double comparatives to emphasize that something is changing. Example, the weather is getting hotter and hotter. So this means, what is the double comparative in this sentence?
It's getting hotter and hotter, so this is a comparative.
Okay, very good. Wow. Okay, so that's what we call double comparative. Why do we use double comparative, Andy? Because
this is getting more and more.
We use double comparative to say that something is changing. Let's just say that the weather today is 35 degrees Celsius. Then by 30 minutes or in 30 minutes, the weather became 40 degrees Celsius. So that means it is changing gradually. That's why we use double comparatives. Okay?
Okay.
Great. Now for number seven, we use the and comparatives to say that one thing changes with another. Can you please read the example?
We use Z and comparatives to say that the most carefully you check your work, the fewer mistakes you will make.
Yes. So we use the plus the. Okay. In the first sentence, the more carefully you check your work, the fewer mistakes you'll make. So what kind of adjective do we use here? Is it comparative or superlative?
Fewer.
Yes, fewer is the adjective. So kind of adjective do we use here? Is it comparative or superlative?
Okay, it's comparative.
Very good. So any questions, Andy?
No.
Okay, so now let's take a look with this one. So here, please remember that there are irregular comparative and superlative forms. So teacher AM, what do you mean by irregular adjectives? So this means, Andy, that the spelling changes when we use the comparative and superlative. Or the word changes. Just like if the adjective is good, then the comparative form is better. The superlative is the best.
Okay.
If the adjective is bad, the comparative is worse. Then the superlative is the worst. Kindly look at the spelling. They're not the same. Right?
Yes.
That's why it is called irregular, comparative, and superlative forms. Just like this one. If the adjective is far, then the comparative is further.
Further.
Then the superlative is the furthest.
Furthest.
Okay. And in here, we have the adverb. If the adverb is well, the comparative is better than the best. If the adverb is badly, that's the same, worse, the worst, far, further, the furthest. So okay. Any more question about this?
No.
Okay, so these are only few examples of irregular, comparative, and superlative form. So now, Andy, let's apply what you have learned. So please match each highlighted phrase in the dialogue with rules A to G.
Okay, the best, the better, the best, good, better, best.
Oh, wait a minute. So in here, kindly look at the highlighted phrases. So we have the best we've seen.
Okay, the best okay. we've seen.
So which rule from A, B, C, A, B, C, D, E, can you match with the best we've seen? So this is letter A. We often use a superlative with the present perfect because the best we have seen or we've seen is a present perfect. How about higher and higher?
Higher and higher are higher and highest.
You don't need to change any. You're just going to match. Higher and higher. So which rule does it apply? It is double comparative.
Okay.
In here, double comparative. So how about we can make comparisons with simple nouns and also with clauses. Can you please tell me the highlighted phrase?
We can make comparisons with simple nouns and also with clauses. The least expensive.
Okay, so this is less expensive than it seems.
Oh, okay.
How about double comparative?
That double compare, higher and higher.
Very good. How about letter D? We use the to say that one thing changes with another.
We use the easy. Oh, the more we spend on rent, the less we'll have the four other things.
Okay, the more we spend on rent. Wow, very good. Okay, so now let's proceed with letter E. We usually use more and most to form comparative. However, we add ER and EST to some short adverbs. Highlighted?
More easily.
More easily. Okay, yes. Very good. How about letter F? Like more and most, we can use less and least with long adjectives. Especially with uncountable nouns.
Accountable. Higher or no? More easily?
Letter E is more easily. So like more and most, we can use less and least with long adjectives, adverbs, and uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns. So which do you think?
Uncountable noun. The fewest room.
Rooms can be counted. We can say one room, two rooms, three rooms. That can be counted. Oh. It's not uncountable. So can you please choose another answer?
More easily. Oh no, the least space.
Very good. The least space and the least expensive. Okay, so now, how about letter G? Fewer and fewest.
The fewest rooms.
Okay, very good. So this is only additional information, Andy. We use the fewest or fewer with countable nouns. Just like rooms, because we can count it. Okay, so now, how many correct answers did you got in here? So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow. So that is 6 out of 8, Andy. Congratulations. Do you have any question about this? Any questions about this, Andy?
Oh, okay. Oh, Jira can hear now.
Hello, Andy.
Hello?
Yes. Do you have any questions? Hello, Andy. What's your question?